my friends, and welcome back for another virtual visit. Today, I am joining you from the third floor in our Edge of the Sea Touch Tank. And I am here with Kristen, one of our amazing aquarists. Kristen is a bridge aquarist, which actually means that she spends her time between multiple areas of the aquarium, including our giant ocean tank and where we're standing right now, our interactive exhibit spaces. And with Kristen's help today, we're gonna talk a little bit more about an exhibit that you might not notice, and that is the exhibit we are standing right next to. This one's easy to overlook, but I think we're gonna learn a little bit more about it today, so hopefully the next time you're in our Edge of the Sea Touch Tank, you'll have a deeper appreciation for this little known exhibit. So I think to get us started off, Kristen, can you tell us a little bit more about this exhibit, what we're showing here, and the animals that call it home?
Yeah, so this is our New England Shore Slant Tank, and basically, as the name implies, you can find everything in here right in New England. More specifically, these guys would be found a little farther offshore in deeper water than, say, the animals you would see in our tide pool touch tank. So we have a lot of cool guys in here. One example is our sea robins that have modified fins that let them walk around on the bottom. We've also got some sculpins in here that are particularly happy in this tank because they've actually laid eggs a couple times. We've also got a few toad crabs, and those guys you'd have to look really hard for because they like to put algae on themselves. So we've actually got one guy hiding over here. And we've also got three female chain cat sharks that like to hang out on the bottom. They're pretty sedentary until you put food in there, and then they get really excited. A lot of the animals might be kind of hard to see in here, but if you know where to look, there's a bunch of them.
So I think the animals in this exhibit are easy to miss for kind of two reasons. One is if you're standing at the touch tank interacting with those animals, your back is literally to this exhibit. And two, Kristen already hinted at this, but the animals in this tank have incredible camouflage. So if you glance over quickly, you might just think it's a tank full of seaweed and you might not be inclined to come on over and take a closer look. But there really is a ton of life in this exhibit. Now, Kristen, from what I understand, there are some unique challenges to this particular exhibit, especially when it comes to things like feeding or cleaning, or maybe a little more involved than some of our other exhibits. Do you think you could tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, how about I show you?
Awesome, that sounds great.
All right, so this is the back of our slant tank. As you can see here, we have a weighted lid. A lot of the fish in this tank are pretty jumpy, so we like to make sure that the lid is nice and secure. But you can see if I open it that there's really not all that much room for your arms to go in there to work on the exhibit. In addition to that, it's also kind of hard to see the front of the tank from back here. The only way you can really look at it is through this tiny strip of glass here. So that presents a few challenges with scrubbing algae, cleaning the sand, and even like moving stuff around or catching fish. So we have a few different tools that we like to use to make it a little bit easier. So we have this algae pad on a stick that helps us get all the way to the front to be able to clean all the different sides of the tank. And we also have these grabbers that we can use to be able to move stuff around or take anything out that we need to. And also back here, we would be doing all of our feeding. So we would put like mysis and shrimp and stuff in there. So would you guys like to see me feed the tank?
Awesome, sounds great.
So this is just some mysis shrimp that we feed these guys. And they love it.
Wow, Kristen, thank you so much. That was really cool to get to see some of our animals kind of come out of the woodwork for that delicious mysis shrimp. Now, is the New England Shore Slant Tank the only exhibit that you access from this kiosk space?
It's not. If you go back around this corner, we can also access our seahorse exhibit, and that's where we would be able to feed them a couple times a day, as well as any maintenance, like cleaning the gravel that we would do in there. So we can do everything from back here.
Kristen, thank you so much for giving us a glimpse behind the scenes for our slant tank today. It was really cool to get to explore this exhibit with you. I know that I have a newfound respect for the aquarists that help to keep these animals healthy, especially in such tight quarters. And I hope all of you at home enjoyed this glimpse behind the scenes at our edge of the sea touch tank. Remember, if you have questions for myself or for Kristen, put those in the comments and we'll answer them for you. And we'll see you back here again soon. Thanks, friends.